We are requested to remove the left recursion from the grammar. And let's see where the left recursion is. It's here, this rule, and the other, this non-terminal is affected. That means in a left recursion, in a dialect left recursion, we have the same non-terminal that's on the left-hand side as first symbol on the right-hand side. And then afterwards, there's anything else. And we may want to remove a left recursion from a grammar because some parsing algorithms have problems with it. Let's do some derivation steps first to see how the left recursion works. For example, if I start with a B and I use the first rule, then I can generate a very long chain of A's. So it would look. In the first step, I would replace B by BA. And then I would replace that B by BA and would be left with Z. And then I would be replacing it again, being left with 3 A's and so on and so on. So as you can see in a left recursion, we always have the same non-terminal symbol on the at the beginning. And if we want to remove that, if you look at the rules, the only way to get rid of those B at the beginning is to use one of these two rules. And that's what we are using when we remove the left recursion. We will create a new rule where this B at the beginning expands to one of those things it has to terminate with at the end. So we would B would terminate with ABC, and then we will add a new non-terminal symbol which we may can call B1, and that's what we are doing for every rule B can terminate with. So we add another rule for the D where B expands to D and to B1. Now we need to add some rules for the B1. In one case, I can directly derivate those B to ABC. So in this case, we wouldn't generate anything afterwards. So for the case where B can directly use that rule, B1 would be empty. So we add B1 expands to the empty symbol. And then we also need to keep track of those left recursion rules. And as you can see here, we can generate a very long string of A's, and we can keep this by saying B expands to A and afterwards another B. So with this rule, we don't have left recursion, but we can still generate our long chain of A's. And we also need to add the same for the B after that non-terminal B in the second rule. So we add B1 expands to B1. Now let's have a look at how those new rules work to generate the same strings. Well, let's say this rule B could terminate by those non-terminal D. So this is the one that we also want to derive with the new rules, and in that case I accidentally changed the size of my pen. In that case we would have our B, and now with our new rules we will have terminate the left recursion by the D, but now we are doing it at the first step by using this rule. So we have now B expands to D, B1. And now we can generate our chain of A's with that rule. So we expand to D, A, B1, and D, A, A, B1, and D, A, 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 B1, and in the last step we would use that rule to get rid of the b1. And now we got the same string as we got with the first rules. Now, this recursion is called direct left recursion. You can directly see that it's there, but there are also something, there might be some indirect left recursion if you have some epsilon rules and you might not see that there's a left recursion in it. So if you want to get rid of all kinds of left recursion, you may have to get rid of the epsilon productions first before applying this. And here you see that we are adding a new epsilon rule. So maybe you will have to get rid of the epsilon rules not just before using this algorithm, but afterwards as well. But at least you will have a grammar without left recursion.